should Sacramento County have been more aggressive with the recommendations for wearing masks in places where vaccination status does not have to be proven?
I think it's important for us to remember that the most important thing that we can do right now to get us out of this the current surge is vaccination. So in Sacramento County, that has been our focus. And of course, we have had discussions about masking, but it's only up to this week when we started seeing a sharp increase in cases that we reassessed that. And that's the reason for putting out the recommendation for masking indoors.
And speaking of those increasing cases, we've reported that there was an expected increase because of the reopening. Was this number what you expected, or do you expect there to even be a greater increase in the number of cases?
Well, it's hard to know, but we are trying everything that we can to make sure that we slow down the spread. And so the messages we're putting out, if you're sick, if you have any symptoms, please stay home. And then also masking and also being careful in large gatherings. And also, again, the most important message is that if you're not vaccinated, please get vaccinated. We are hoping that we will be able to bend the curve quickly, because that's what we really want to do, is get to that plateau and start seeing a reduction in cases. So it's hard to say how long it's going to take us, but we are definitely working hard to get out there, get people vaccinated, and also get the message out about how people can keep themselves safe.
Sure, but let me ask it a different way. So when there was news that the county was and the state was reopening, obviously many health experts have said that there was an increase of cases to be expected. Based on your knowledge of, you know, the county and what was to be expected, what did you expect? What numbers did you expect to see go up as the state and the county reopened?
What we expected was that there'd be a little bit of an increase in cases and a small increase, maybe 1 or 2 percentage points in increase in the case rate. But what we're seeing now is that the numbers are continuing to climb. And again, our concern is with the increase in the number of cases that are sequenced to be the Delta variant. And as we know, the Delta variant is more contagious. And so there is concern that we might be seeing a further increase in our cases.
And what is the concern that this increase in cases could lead to businesses having to be shut down again, or there to be more travel restrictions throughout the county?
At this point, there is no consideration of that. One is that we do have a substantial number of our population vaccinated. And when you look on our dashboard, if you look at the map, especially for the last 30 days, you will see that the number of affected zip codes with high case numbers has reduced. It's just that we do have these hotspots, and they tend to overlay with the areas that have low vaccination rates. So that points to what we need to do, which is to continue with the vaccination, because once we are able to do that, we expect that the case rates will begin to go down.